We're gonna win.
Oh, go, go, go.
Come on, go. We gotta go.
We're gonna lose.
We're not gonna lose.
They're gone. You're out here.
And if we don't get anything, we don't have anything.
Right,
one more time.
I'm telling you, I think
come
we
on,
should pull, go.
Yeah. Roar wins immunity and reward.
Roar.
Yeah. Immunity challenge! Carr wins their fifth straight immunity!
Carr wins immunity for the sixth straight time! Carr wins immunity again!
Oolong, I wish I had better news. Tribal council, it's not.
I'm not starting off Guatemala on the losing team.
Villains win first immunity challenge!
Jacob wins the award!
I've been an athlete my entire life. I'm just not a good loser. I don't understand how this tribe continues to lose the way it does. And I'm not good with it. I'm not good with losing.
Bobby Johnson in the car kicking his legs, cheering like a freaking girl. I wanted to knock him out.
I'm jealous.
Jealousy gets you nowhere.
Basically.
He's so gay. He gets so gay. I can't stand it.
So make it bad thing. I'm just pissed. I mean, I'm sick of losing. I can't do this again, but I am just trying really hard when I'm up at camp to keep my mouth shut. I'm never going to cry in front of any of them, ever. And I'm never going to tell them how I really feel, but deep down, I mean, my heart is breaking. I'm completely shocked and surprised, and I'm embarrassed. I wish we could have won, but everything happens for a reason. I know I did the best I could. You want to think I'm a threat? I'll show you after I hang.
It wasn't even. You didn't vote for me that night, did you?
No.
Well, then it had to be you.
I voted for Angie.
You didn't sound like a guy's hand, right?
She had to go. We couldn't lose you. I don't like to lie, but this was in the midst of we were deciding who we're going to vote out tonight, so there's no way in hell I could have told him the truth. So I said, I swear to God, it wasn't me.
And we may feel right now like we get together, we get a hand off.
And Steph, that's really what we're getting at this first tribal council, is there's a reason to get rid of every single person up here.
Well, I think as far as trying to make a decision tonight, it's the first one, and that's the hardest, I think, but we don't want to come back here.
The fact remains that I've worked my butt off, and I've done the best I could, and I've done really well so far, so I just feel like it's really not my time yet, and I just hope that they see that too.
It's the plan, you're the weakest.
If someone's gonna slit your throat just because you like their company, hell no.
Judd.
Thanks, guys. Hope you guys all get bit by a freaking crocodile. Scumbags.
Outwitted, outplayed, and outlast every single one of them. And that's why I'm in the final two and they're not.
Student, and when I saw Stephenie dislocate her shoulder, I knew she could leave the game permanently over something like that.
Now medical look at it?
What happens if medical looks at it?
Hold there. Stay here. Medical!
Ah! Hi. Your shoulder's popped out.
Yeah, we're going down. Can we just kneel down for me?
Hold up.
Hold it up? Like that?
Yep. Just need someone to go over there.
Hang tight, okay?
The villains are brutal. They've dislocated my shoulder. The first challenge. I mean, really? Like, you're already on the villain tribe. You have to act like a total, like, jerk?
It's okay now.
Wow.
All right.
Oh my God.
This is crazy.
It's just you.
It's just me now.
What do you think tonight's gonna be like?
It's gonna be scary. I mean, I left camp with the fire pretty stoked and my bed already made in case I was coming back to it and lots of firewood, so kind of scared. Hopefully I'll have a good night and tomorrow, God knows what that brings.
We'll see what tomorrow brings. Grab your torch, head on back to camp. You're still alive.
It's exciting being the last Oolong member. At the same time, it was really scary because it's just me now.
Hopefully this fire is still lit. Scariest thing and the hardest thing that I'll ever do. But I'll never give up. I'm not a quitter. I don't know what else to do. It's tough. But if I win, it'll be worth it.
I outwitted and outplayed and outlasted the best that I knew how to, and that's why I'm sitting here in the final two, and that's why I would be honored to have your votes as the sole survivor.
You are the ultimate survivor.
The winner of Survivor Guatemala. Steph.
Steph. Nobody ever in that situation before. One tribe member left, spending the night out on your own. Did you know going in that you had that in you? I mean, you're an athlete. Obviously, you've been in a lot of competition, but that was severe circumstances.
Yeah, it was. I knew I'd be all right in the challenges to a certain extent. I didn't know how I would fare with no food. And then losing every single immunity challenge was like really, no, not your fault. That was really, really tough. So, no, I mean, I didn't know. I had no idea I was, you know, going to be able to do that well.
Was there a defining moment when you think back on your time out there where it all crystallized and you knew you were all right?
It was probably that night when I was by myself. It's like, I can't get any worse than this. I'm the last one left. I mean, there's nothing, like, you know, here by myself. I don't know what's going to happen. And then I got to join Karoor. Then I was like, forget it. I can do anything now.
So coming in, you know you're going to have a target on your back. Mm-hmm. How did that impact how you played this game from day one?
Well, for me coming in, it was pretty difficult because I was like, well, I'm probably not going to get past the first tribal council, first of all. So I'm going to have to obviously do everything I can to try to get sort of far. So the first thing in my mind is I'm going to have to take a leadership role. I can't sit back. I'm definitely going and make a good alliance. And I did. I made a major alliance with Rafe and a few other people, and it got me all the way to the end.
Were you worried? Because in Palau, the first time you played, you were sort of the sweetheart. And everybody loved Stephenie and how she played. Well, that's hard. That expectation is hard to live up to a second time. Did it go through your head I might be risking the way people see me if I play a tougher game?
Absolutely. I mean, I guess I did come off as America's sweetheart, but also coming into Guatemala, I wasn't playing for seventh place. So I knew that I had to play hard. And I'm the same person I was on Palau. I mean, you may have seen a different side of me. That's me. Take them both, mash them together, get a common denominator, I don't know what, but you know, I am who I am, I'm a nice person, but I had to make some tough decisions, and you know, I hurt a few people along the way.
But Jeff, I'll tell you this, it's nothing that a filet mignon pizza can't cure at my restaurant. GG Restaurant and Lounge. Jeff, what else do I have? Come on, I've
played for 16. You seem to be, okay, good. Congratulations to you. I'm glad you have a restaurant going.
Thank you.
Another element of having both Bobby John and Steph was there was a sense of starstruck. You're one of the most popular women, certainly, to ever play Survivor.
I don't know, it's weird, you know? I'm so grateful that everybody's been so supportive. Thank you, everybody. Everywhere I go, people, you know, come up to me and they say, you know, you're my daughter's hero or you're my hero. And it's just a nice thing to hear, I guess. I get a lot of letters.
You know, you represented this ideal of great competitor, physical. also, you know, shoulder halfway out of your body on day one. You never really got up to speed.
No, I mean, I was, like, very grateful to come back a third time. And I knew that there was a good chance I was going to go very early in this game. I mean, there's, like, probably three of us here that really doesn't hang out with any of these other people. So, then the shoulder dislocation was extremely unfortunate.
In two seasons, you definitely set a couple of records. 46 challenges you took part in. You won 10, you lost 36 times. On the flip side, you survived enough to make it through 25 tribal councils. Now, you got voted out twice, but it really does say a lot for how well you played this game, because it's tough to survive that many votes. So hats off to you for that.
It's nothing that a filet mignon pizza can't cure at my restaurant.